see it's been a while. Just sitting here missing your kisses. Long, long time, just waiting to see you smile. Waiting to see you smile. Well, I met you last year at the show, so afraid of letting you know, so afraid of the pain, I tried to convince you to stay, didn't want you to go. See, I want to get back with you, and I don't know just what to do. And my money's all gone, my friends left me here all alone. Well, you see, it's been a while, just sitting here missing your kisses. Long, long time. Waiting to see a smile.
Now, is that a brand new one?
Yeah.
How old is that, Eric? I've not heard that before.
Well, it is... couple months, maybe?
Yeah. Something like that.
Yeah, a couple months old, maybe. It's called it's called Gravy Davy.
Really?
Yeah.
It's kind of got a nice churchy feel to it.
Yeah, it's...
We're all about the church here at the Dukes of Hubbard.
We are. We
He's going to get us started.
Yeah.
Reverend Ben is holding forth this afternoon.
Yeah.
Is that why you're on your knees all the time?
That's true.
Well.
But, Eric, is that your own, or who...
Yeah. I wrote that tune.
Where did it come from?
It came from me being up for a really long time and missing everybody, and writing a song about a banjo player friend of mine named Dave and a woman.
Nice.
More.
Yeah.
Well, not to sound too much like a Grateful Dead song, huh?
Yeah. Well, it may have been the long hours awake. May have had some effect on the tune, I think. I don't know. It's just a good old-fashioned blues tune.
We like it. The Dukes of Hubbard this afternoon, and again, you can enjoy them tonight at the Brew House, and next weekend at Spirit Mountain, and we go from there. Well, let's take at least a few minutes to talk about Planet Reid, guys. That's the newest thing that I know of. You finished it last fall sometime? Yeah, great.
We released it on Halloween.
And tell me about... First of all, for young players, if we could be serious for just a moment, for young players, it takes a chunk of change. It takes a few grand to put together a disc of any kind. How did you arrange finances for it?
We paid as we went. We didn't want to get into debt for it, so we used gigs and we recorded the album and we paid off our studio time. And then when we had enough money saved up, we paid for the burning, basically, and we got 1,000 copies of it. And we've gotten rid of, I'd say, probably over half of those. So,
great.
So there's 500 people who know who we are.
Okay. Yeah. 500 yet to come who
right,
will
exactly.
find out in the next few months. Well, how did you decide to do it at Sacred Heart? Because off the top of my head, that's a great space for a lot of types of music, but I wouldn't necessarily immediately think that you would be the right fit. How did it work out?
Well, I think it was just because it was the best studio around, I think, in the area, as far as we knew, you know.
And Swanson. We heard nothing but good things.
Yeah, we wanted to make sure we got
and Swanson and Shiv. Shiv.
Shiv.
We know Eric, but we don't know the Shiv.
Yeah, he's got some weird business practices.
Yeah, he shivved Russ's mom.
Okay. Stabbed her right in the stomach.
This may be more information than Eric himself would like us to know. How did you find let's talk about the space itself. How did that work? Jim, I'm curious for your guitars and stuff, because it's got like a multi-second delay, 3 or 4 second delay in there. How did it work?
It just sounded like playing live. You know, that's how we set up. We just played it like any show. It felt like a show. You know, everything was live except for the vocals. We even did a vocal scratch take, you know.
Did you try to make use of the whole space, little rooms, the big room, this and that, or did you just kind of set up
just
to play?
Right up on the stage, just really? Like always. Yeah, real comfortable, very comfortable.
And
a lot of it was take one, you know, just like I think 90% of the album is take one.
Really?
Yep.
Wow, so you didn't have to spend much time in the studio at all.
No.
Did you? Now, you did have some guests and you had percussion and various things on there. Did that come a little bit later, or how did that work out?
Yeah, Minnesota Mike Johnson from the White Iron Band sat in with us on banjo and pedal steel, playing some real nice stuff. He didn't know the tunes, we just wrote them out charts. He came there after we'd laid down the main tracks and just, you know, he filled in some space on it and did a really good job of it, so you'll hear him all over that. He plays banjo on Anne Marie and pedal steel on Castaway.
Mm-hmm. Also Eric Berry. And
Eric Berry,
Rob Linneman.
Brett McKenzie.
Brett McKenzie, Ernie.
Yep. Ernie. Ernie, no last name. Yeah.
We had a cast of thousands then. A lot of people helping out. Well, what is your main? What are your thoughts, Russ? Tell me what you think about the, finished project. Is it what you had hoped it would be, or is it exceeded expectations?
Well, it's kind of our. I mean, really, my first experience in the studio, so I really don't have anything to compare it against. So, I mean, it sounds pretty good. It sounds kind of like a live show, and you know, it's kind of what we do anyway. So, you know, the whole live business, and so it's It's cool.
Ben, did you compress some tunes, things that you play longer, you know, that you extend on stage?
Oh, definitely. We played shorter versions of, you know, a lot of the stuff we normally play, 10, 12, 14-minute versions of. We played in 5, 6-minute versions of, which are still really pretty long for studio tracks. Mm-hmm. But we just kind of got up there, and we wrote out a basic song structure for the stuff that we normally wouldn't write a song structure out for, and we laid down versions of them, and then... Actually, the hardest part of the whole process was probably, like for me anyway, was just getting the sound of the vocals over the top of it to sound how we wanted it to, you know? So that was tough, and in fact, we had to actually get naked for some of that.
thus the Shiv comes in handy again.
Yes.
Well, tell you what, is there another one you guys would like to do, whether it's something
Absolutely.
From Planet Reid or something newer, or you tell
this
me.
This is something newer.
Yeah. All right.
Dukes of Hubbard this afternoon here on KUMD.
Drive me insane, having trouble getting the lies out of my brain. Please welcome. I walked right through that door and I wish you would leave me anymore. Come on, Rusty. Your blue eyes, baby, driving crazy. Till the morning.
bluegrass added to the, or has bluegrass always been a fundamental part of what you've done?
Yes, a little bit, yeah.
A little bit.
Well, we like it all.
It fits in this particular format a lot. Do you guys play in this? This is very much like what people can enjoy tonight at the Brewhouse. Yeah. Is that something you do occasionally or almost never?
You know, we've never really done this.
Yeah, never at all.
Oh,
this
really?
Is new for us.
Oh.
We did it at the tap room once.
This is how we practice.
So occasionally, yes.
Okay. Well, it's going to be fun tonight. And this setting, this style, lends itself exactly to that particular stuff. So we get kind of some different material this afternoon. How much material have you guys been writing even since Planet Reid? Jim, you mentioned something about almost an album's worth of new material. Is that true?
Yeah, we're thinking about maybe even a double album. I mean, we've got a lot of new material.
Really?
So, yeah.
And Planet Reid is only a few months since its release. Is this something that's... What's the writing process for you guys? Is it collective? Is it always individual and somebody bring... How does it work out?
Well, I'd say me, Eric, and Ben write the most. I mean, we've kind of... Everyone will come in with an idea. And
are you, Jimi, the if I remember right, you handle a lot of the music part and Eric handle a lot of the lyric, or how does the division of labor break
Eric
down?
Eric does a lot of the lyrics, Ben does a lot of the lyrics, and I do a lot of the arranging, but Eric has a lot of, you know, just straight out ideas, so I don't know.
We do a lot of individual, we do a lot of individual songwriting too, like I'll write a song, or Eric write a song, or Jimi write a song, and then we'll just bring it to the band, and everybody really contributes to the songwriting process as a whole band, because really the song isn't a Dukes of Hubbard song until the whole band plays it.
Well, how about putting your stamp on, I told these guys as soon as they came in that I am feverishly working on an album of Bob Dylan covers done live in the music room. We've got some really good ones from Greg Brown and Stacey Earle and a bunch of people. Is there a Bob Dylan tune in your repertoire, your vast repertoire of things that you could pull out this afternoon? We'd love to.
Well, John, we enjoy all the fruits of the musical tree.
Excellent.
And
I've been waiting to say that.
I believe we do have a Robert Dylan tune.
Allen Zimmerman. Well, then let's have it. The Dukes
of Hubbard. I heard there was a sighting of him in Duluth recently.
Is that right?
He went and
kind of like Bigfoot.
I heard he bought like 30 or 60 of the Duluth Does Dylan shirts and skedaddy.
Really? You know more than I, then. All right. We'll believe
you. Know what
you.
I heard, too? If you put Pop Rocks in your mouth. Well, never mind.
No. What is that?
Not,
what is that?
Not really.
All right. The Dukes of Hubbard.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1.
Well, you know, to sit and wonder why, baby, if you don't know by now. Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, it never do anyhow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone, and you'll be the reason I'll be traveling on. Don't think twice, it's all right. And there ain't no use in turning on your light, baby. Light I never know. And there ain't no use in turning on your light, baby. I'm on the dark side of the road. I'm wishing there was something you would do or say. Make me change my mind. We never did too much talking anyway. Don't think twice, it's alright. Sitting, wondering, walking down the road,
I once loved a woman, a child I'm told. I gave my heart, but you wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's all right.
Very nice. Thank you very much. I'm glad that we did that. Tim Saxog, the bassist, and Eric Pollard sharing the vocals, and Rusty doing the keyboard licks. In fact, Eric Pollard playing guitar on that one. Eric,
yes.
Multi-talented young man over there. Very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, Tim, I'm going to come back to you. Were you serious about that? I don't know anything, but were you just making that up?
What?
The Dylan sighting.
No, I heard that too from a different person.
Yeah, I've heard it from a couple people.
Really? When did this happen?
A couple days ago, what?
Yeah, so it would be like Wednesday, maybe.
Literally, Bob himself pops in.
Ladies and gentlemen, there has been a Bob Dylan sighting in Duluth.
Really? I had not heard this.
Was that Advantage Emblem and screen printing? Was that was that where that was?
Morgan Park?
I believe so. Out in Friendly, Morgan Park.
Turn these mics and phones off right now. Well, that's interesting. No, I had not heard that. That's great. Well, thank you for doing that. It shows the breadth and depth of the Dukes of Hubbard repertoire this afternoon. Jim, let me go back in time. You're originally from the Bemidji area? Are more than one of you? Is the Dukes of Hubbard kind of a Park Rapids Bemidji confluence here?
There's more Hubbard County in there than Bemidji,
and thus the name.
Well, the Park Rapids, Grand
the Park Rapids. Rapids, yeah. That's where me and Ben met.
How did the band come together? And I know there are some early bands, so let me ask quickly about Anomaly and the Stepping Stones.
Oh God. Well, actually,
Rusty
is going to get in here.
Yeah, I played with Anomaly in Bemidji when I went to school over there, and that's kind of how I met some of the guys. I met Jimi and I met Ben, and then actually their drummer quit and joined the Navy, and so.
That's a sad recommendation.
Out of nowhere, and so
he wanted to sail the seven seas.
I had been playing with Timmy and Eric for several years in high school and stuff in a different band, and then their drummer quit, and so they were without a drummer and a bass player, and so we just kind of joined up together. And
Rusty, how do you describe Anomaly?
Anomaly was kind of a butt rock, Doors,
brown eyed girl,
kind of bar band, ZZ Top. Yeah, right.
They had a talent.
Yeah, really? It was fun, man. It was cool.
Was Stepping Stones followed Anomaly?
Oh no. Stepping Stones was way back, like when I was still in high school. Jimi and I, and a guy named Nate Johnson, and a guy named Pat St. Clair had a. Basically a cover band that played everything from
Green Day to Alice in Chains.
Alice in Chains to ZZ Top and whatever. We played local bowling alleys.
Really? The name, the Stepping Stones, I'm curious, from that old tune or from,
yep.
Really?
Yeah, that's the sad part.
Monkeys
it was
tune.
Actually,
wow.
And we played the song.
Is that, well, I know what I want to know. No. Well, that's interesting. So Hubbard County plays a role in the background for sure, and Park Rapids and Bemidji and et cetera, et cetera.
Oh, yeah.
How do you guys describe, Eric, when friends ask you, what are the Dukes of Hubbard? What do you sound like? How do you describe verbally?
All I say is that we are a rock and roll band. That's it.
Okay.
Because you really have to come to a show.
It's kind of hard to pinpoint exactly what style we do, and people ask us a lot, and it's really an eclectic mix, and it's like well, we can't really categorize ourselves because we kind of run the gamut, you know. I mean, anything from jazz to bluegrass to classical, even to rock and roll to you know anything that yeah. we you know anything that's good we play.
Grease,
so.
We just grease up the gamut.
Tell me about Eugene.
Oh.
Is this something that
we've never played it before.
Yeah,
I've never played it.
We've got a debut this afternoon. Then who wrote
a couple of them?
Set it up a little bit for us, Ben or Eric.
It's Eric.
I'll set it up. This is a tune that let me see. It would have been last February. We were going through some tough times with family members and friends passing away late January, and my grandpa passed away. And I wrote this tune about him. His name is Eugene Pollard.
All right. Yeah, Dukes of Hubbard.
Yeah. What? Yeah.
We've never played this before.
I've never even heard it before.
There, so.
Everyone I know, now I know it is my time. 81 years have passed, I've accepted the call. Soon you will be grieving, and I'll sure miss you all. But I know, yes, I know, that it's my time to go. A saint of a mother raised me well, and it's come time again to see her. Who knows if she'll remember me, and will there be a heaven or a hell? It's come time to wait and see. My old bones are growing weak, the wife and family are losing too much sleep. But I know, yes I know, that it's my time to go. Come on, Jimi. Up at the stars when you think of me, gleaming back at you. Dig deep, accept inevitability, 'cause you knew it was my time. And I hope and I pray that I'll see you all someday, way up in the clouds on streets of gold. 'Cause I'm growing old, now I know that it's my time to go. Yes, I'm growing old, now I know that it's my time to go.
Okay, I think Grandpa would have been proud, or words to that effect.
Oh, thanks, John.
That's quite amazing, though. When you started playing that, are you aware of the harmonic, melodic, and rhythmic similarities? To Don't Think Twice, I seriously was going to jump in and say, guys, you've got the wrong chord chart.
We were going to split those two up.
Yeah, we were going to split us on the spot.
I'm sorry.
All right, you figured us out.
They're in different keys.
We only know six chords, John.
I'm sorry.
They're all Bob Dylan, too.
And really about eight bars into it, Jimmy, I was seriously going to say, you got the Don't Think Twice changes.
Yeah, there's a couple of different chords.
Actually, Don't Think Twice is in G, and this one was in C, so it's kind of a similar progression, but it's a different key.
Give Bob and this one's about partial Eugene. Writing credit. And
I do. Yes. He's a big influence to us all. Really.
Tell me about, you guys were in the Battle of the Bands that takes place on Thursday night.
I think we lost.
Did you? I didn't. I'm not sure of.
I think we're still in fifth place. So I think they take the top five. I don't know. We really haven't been paying attention.
What was the experience like? Did you enjoy it? Because it's got to be
a fuse. That was fun. Right on the first song.
Really?
Yeah.
That's got to be unique when you know somebody is out there judging you and you could, you know, get a studio time or something. What's your memory? Ben, what did you think when you went through that?
The speakers were so loud, I wet myself, actually.
And isn't life just really a giant process of people judging you?
Yes. You know, it was a good time. It was a good time playing down there. That's a cool room to play in, which nobody really ever gets a chance to play in, but... we were the first band to do it.
So for a week at least, you were in first place.
Right. Well, actually, I think we were
like about three weeks,
couple weeks, but it was it was a gig like any other, and we had a good time doing it, and hopefully we'll make it to the next level of competition, and hopefully win some free crap because we're all about the free crap.
So is public radio. So hey, we're in the right spot.
It is that. It all works out.
When you guys are traveling around, if you're heading up to Bemidji or you're going up to, you're going to play down at the Caboose, I understand, in the next month or two.
13th of February, I think, we're at the Caboose. We play in St. Cloud next week. We're in Fargo, I believe, the week after that.
When you guys are on the road,
When
you're on the road, what are the allowable artists to put in the CD player? You got some commonalities if you're traveling together?
Frank Zappa. Nothing but Zappa.
You know, I literally wrote Zappa down to ask you about that.
Frank Zappa and the Carpenters. That's
And then with Timmy and I, it's
Ronnie James Dio.
Like, with Timmy and I, it's usually... like Leonard Cohen, the Dead Man.
Ween.
And Ween.
Yes, lots
and,
of Ween.
How does Leonard Cohen get in there? That's wild.
Timmy has a mixtape with some Leonard Cohen.
Really? Like I'm a Man or
well, some of it's like stuff from the future, you know, that period, and then some's earlier stuff.
Really?
Back from when he sounded like he wasn't, you know.
Is there a Leonard Cohen tune in your repertoire? This. Wow.
Well, John, not that mysterious.
What else is new that you guys would like to do? Tim, are you holding up something you want to do? Is there another new one?
It's another one we haven't done before.
This is called The Old Lady.
Yeah, this
is
another premiere.
This is a partial preview of tonight, partial radio performance, and partial rehearsal for the Dukes of Hubbard this afternoon.
It's a rehearsal for the night. You got it right.
All right. Jim, set this up. This is The Old Lady, I see.
It's about a couple old ladies.
Okay.
This is one Jimmy wrote.
Yeah, I don't know how to set it up. Here we go. I hope Russ knows the chords.
Just play tambourine or something.
Russ, can you play the tambourine?
I was going to play the tambourine.
I'm waiting for Rusty to pull out the trombone again here.
We'll do that a little later here.
Days for you. For years she believed in that faith in the cross, though at times sensing something was wrong. As a child she was taught not to live her own way, but follow the good book instead. She'd obey every rule, even when they seemed strange, for the town was the sound of a fool. People she knew were all set in their ways and condemned those who lived for the day. They
drink and marry. Though the preacher had said they would pay for their unholy ways. After many years passed, she could not bear the thought that her life had been wasted away. So remember, my friends, to live life till the end, for I may never be here again. Left her old man, for he would not believe, though he loved her and wanted to stay. She spent all her nights with her Bible in bed. All alone she would cry in her sleep. One day as she sat in the old rocking chair, thinking over beliefs that she'd had, then realize she'd invested in lies, but it's too late, the damage was done. After many years passed, she could not bear the thought that her life had been wasted away. So remember, my friends, to live life till the end, for may never be here again. Time was now lost as she looked at the days of her youth.
That's an interesting song. Jimi, what inspired that? Is there some woman, older woman near where you live that you saw walking down the street? Or
that's a good question. It's a combination. It's really? A combination. That's kind of about my grandma. And that's kind of about divorce, so.
And kind I'll of, just a, leave it kind at of that. A wasted life and finding religion, and maybe it didn't do it for her, and some variety of things. Who knows?
Work out it, in the end is yeah. kind of how that one goes.
Well, the old lady asked for it tonight when you Get see right these the guys at the time. Brew House. Big thanks this afternoon to Gordon Hart and Brian Houle from Midwest Concert Concepts for being here and helping make this sound good this afternoon. We appreciate you guys being here. I'm curious, even in your guys' tenure. What have you seen? I'm not letting you go yet. What have you seen in the local music scene? Is it today, 2004, easier to get gigs in Duluth, harder to get gigs? What have you seen?
It's easy for us to get gigs in Duluth, but we find that if we play in Duluth every week or whatever, that we tend to wear ourselves out in playing in Duluth, and more importantly, we tend to wear those that are listening to us in Duluth out of listening to us. Is that grammatically correct?
You got it.
So we're trying to play out of town more.
Oh, yeah. And is it easy to forge new territory, or is that tough? Is it adventure? Is it dread? When you go to a new venue, a new town, whatever, how do you approach that?
Well, we go to new towns, and there's always going to be someone at the place you're playing, whether it's 50 people or 250 people. And we always, you know, we manage to walk into a place and play, and people are usually at least, you know, happy with the fact that, you know, we're up there and we're pretty tight. I mean, we don't get up there and play a loose show. But, you know, this being an acoustic show, we do pretty well, but we play a lot of pretty eclectic stuff when we play electrically, and we get pretty noisy sometimes, so we tend to drive some people out of the room.
Well, loud is good. Ben, yeah. Loud is good. As an old guitar player, I always felt that was the right maxim. Well, Jimi, you got a shaker. Rusty's got the trombone. What are you set to do? And let's hear another tune from the Dukes of Hubbard this afternoon.
This is one called Us. Guys, ready?
Mm-hmm.
One, two, three. You, I wonder how you knew to make my dreams come true. What you do to me, you make me so happy. You make me want to be permanently with you. I have never been the guy afraid to walk away
day. But you, you make me want to stay. You make me want to say every day I love you.
We haven't played that one in quite some time.
I like that. That's a
thanks.
I love that groove. Mr. Cooper, music adjunct faculty member, is that a bossa? Is that a samba? Is that what is that exactly?
That's a bossa.
Oh, I like that. I love those Ben, I like those 13 chords in there. That's got a really nice vibe to it.
Thanks.
Us from the Dukes of Hubbard this afternoon. And I asked these guys if not only could they do a Dylan tune, but I went so far as to say, is there a Lennon McCartney tune that might be possible to do this afternoon? If you could do a Lennon McCartney tune, then maybe one of your choosing, we'll let you guys go and get set up tonight. We're getting a preview right now of the Dukes of Hubbard, and they're going to be tonight at the Brew House and down the line next weekend at Spirit Mountain, and then further down the line in February at the Caboose and St. Cloud and other places. Ben, is the Dukes of Hubbard website so people can go and see?
Yeah, I think it's going. We got a website, right?
It's a page right now.
It's
we're
a
working on the website.
Okay.
It's www.dukesofhubbard.com.
So stop by tonight at the Brew House and ask where you can see more shows down the line.
Can we also say hello real quick to our friends at Lake Superior Brewery, Mike and Rick and Don. And Dale.
Is that Mike Lottie?
That'd be Mike Lottie.
The
he likes the potty.
Well, we're going to rewind.
He ain't hurting nobody.
Okay. Is it possible to get a Lennon McCartney tune out of the ensemble
this
afternoon?
It's very possible.
Out of the orchestra? We'd love it.
We've known to play some Beatles tunes. We've been known.
Yep. Whatever, Jim.
Won't you come out to play? Dear Prudence, greet the brand new day. The sun is up, the sky is blue, it's beautiful. So are you, dear Prudence. Won't you come out to play? Dear Prudence, open up your eyes. Dear Prudence, the sunny skies. The wind is low, birds are sing, the chew upon of everything dear prudence. Won't you open up your eyes? Look around, look around, look around. Dear Prudence, let me see you smile. A daisy chain, so let me see your smile again, dear Prudence. Oh, won't you let me see you smile? Dear Prudence, won't you come out to play?
Rattlesnakes in the studio.
Hey, that's nice. Very nice, you guys. Thank you. Tim Saxog again doing the vocals this afternoon. And it's been fun to have you guys. Is there one of your own that you would like to go out with? Either something from Planet Reid or another new one?
I think. Let's.
You can't say ass kicker on the radio, Russ.
Rusty has been planning to do that Dio song this afternoon.
This is this is Shame on the Night. By Ronnie James Dio.
Oh, what do you guys want to do?
No.
Let's do Dukes. Yeah,
let's do Dukes.
Okay, we're gonna do a tune by the band.
All right.
Because you asked us last time to do a tune by the band, and we did.
I would love to.
Because we wanted to play all our own stuff.
That's perfectly okay. Well, you guys have been very cooperative this afternoon. Couldn't be more proud. Jimi Cooper on guitar, Eric Pollard vocals, guitar, and percussion this afternoon. Tim Saxog on bass, Rusty Sackett on keyboards. Ben, did I screw up your last?
Oh, that's all right. It's actually Whitesnake.
Ben Whitesnake this afternoon.
Thank you.
Guys, thanks very much. The Dukes of Hubbard, you can catch them tonight at the Brewhouse. The band, Night They Drove Old Dixie?
Yeah.
All right.
One, a two, a three.
Virgil Payne was a name and I served on the Danville train. To Stormer's cavalry came, tore up the tracks again. In the winter of 65, we were hungry, just barely alive. By May the 10th, the Richmond affair. The night they drove old Dixie down, and all the bells were ringing. The night they drove old Dixie down, and all the people were singing. They went na 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 na. Back when my to me, Virgil, quick, come see, there goes the rock.
chopping wood, and I don't care if the money's no good. You take what you get and you leave the rest. But they should never have taken the very best. The night they drove old Dixie down, and all the bells were ringing. The night they drove old Dixie down, and all the people were singing. They went la 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 la. Like my father before me, I must work the land. Like my brother before me, who took a rebel stand. He was just 18, proud and brave, till the Yankee laid him in his grave. I swear by the blood below my feet, the can't raise a gate back up when it's in me. The night they drove old Dixie down, and all the bells were ringing. The night they drove old Dixie down, and all the people were singing. They went la 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 la.
Very nice. Thank you very much for doing that. That was a very, very nice version.
Oh, thank you, John.
Well, guys, it's been fun to have you this afternoon. You're always welcome. Come back anytime.
It's been nice being
here. Thanks, man. It's always great to be here.
Ben and Eric and Tim and Rusty and Jim, and best of luck tonight at the Brew House. Get out and...
and a
big thanks this afternoon to Brian Houle and to Gordon Hart of Midwest Concert Concept. Big thanks to everybody.
I'll tell you that, Brian Houle, he's something else, man.